So let's look now at the different x of k. So let's look at different x of k. And so we know that we would like to explore the lowest frequency and the highest frequency. So the very lowest frequency is obviously the DC. So let's start with the DC. So this means we would like to have so x of n is constant. So how do we do that? Yeah, so if we have our sequence here from x0 to x n minus 1, then we set this one, this the first coefficient here to 1, and all the other coefficients here, we set them to 0. Yeah, so we set this one here to 0. So this is the first frequency coefficient. This is a so-called DC coefficient. So if we write this down with our formula here again, so if you write x of n, and then it's 1 over n, sum k equals 0, n minus 1, and then we have here our x of k, so our frequency coefficients, and then j 2 pi, set here k, n divided by the number of samples. Okay, so of this x of 0 here, so the very first one here, this is only 1. Yeah, so that's our DC coefficient which goes in there. And so this means if we are applying this sequence here to the special case here, then so what is left? Then we have 1 over n, and then only the very first coefficient here for k equals 0 is left. So this means then this goes away here, and we have got e to j 2 pi. And then remember the k, only the k 0 is there. So this means this here multiplies by 0 multiplied by n divided by n. And so then this whole term here is just 1. And so that's our result here. So the x of n is just a constant value, what I wanted to have here. So is that actually the case? So if we go here to spider. So what I've already prepared here is just for cut and paste purposes here. Let's just copy this here into the Python, an array of 1,000 zeros here. Oops, need to run this here first. So then we have here an array of in this x here just zeros. And and so what we want to do is we would like to set this very first coefficient here to 1 and leave the rest just to 0. So let's do that so that I set the very first coefficient to 1. And so now we can do a inverse Fourier transform on this. Let's call this here xf equals to numpy fft iFFT of x. Okay, so let's have a look what xf tells us here. So we see it's just a constant value, and remember the length, the inverse Fourier transform has a property of dividing everything by n. So with 1,000 samples, this gives us here division by n, so just a constant value. So if I So you see we've got a j here, but that's all zero. So we get just a constant 0.001 here. PLT plot numpy real of xf. Where's the figure? There's the figure. So we see here getting a nice constant DC value out of that. That's what we wanted to have for the very first coefficient. Okay, so then let's move on to the lowest frequency in the next clip.